trials, walk with me. In my troubles, walk with me. In my sorrow, walk with me. While I'm going through the valley of Baca, walk with me. People come to church all the time. Can't say nothing. Can't feel nothing. Mainly because they ain't been through nothing. You must know God for yourself. You must know Jesus for yourself. You must know the Holy Spirit for yourself.
Yes.
Again, in verse 6, as they go through the valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. While Baca may look deserted on the surface, the psalmist reminds us if our strength is in the Lord, if there is a highway in our heart when we travel through the valley of Baca, we can transform the desert into a spring. We can turn the Bakers in our lives into an oasis of hope. Recently, I was watching a documentary on volcanoes. I was really bored. Now, I got 500 channels. One thing I can find is a documentary on volcanoes.
That's all right.
It was in the volcano they were looking for gold. And on the surface, there was no gold to be seen. But they got down this little, whatever it was, let them down about 5,000 feet. Found more gold than know what to deal with. On the surface, what you're going through may seem hopeless. But if you just go down a little deeper,
yes,
there's a spring under your bed. There's a fountain of life-giving water under your bed. There are more blessings than you will know what to do with under your bed. In every bed, there's a sorrow. There's a spring of comfort. In every baker of weeping, there's a spring of joy. In every baker of heartbreak, there's a spring of thanksgiving. You can't find it on the surface. You got to dig down in the valley. The spring is there for those whose faith teaches them to dig deep. You can't find the spring if you're not willing to dig deep below the depths of the surface. You can't find the spring if all you want to do is stay on the surface and criticize other folks. To find the spring, you got to be willing to dig deep. You must dig past the pain, past the hurt, past the disappointment, past the setback. If you're willing to dig deep, God will step out of nowhere and turn your pain into a spring. We don't gain strength from the high points of life. It's the low points, the pain. But we find our strength. As nice as the high point of God, there's no strength there. Instead, when I need to go back and I need some strength, I don't go back to the high places. I go back to the banks. I go back to the low points. I think about the times I was beat and scorned and talked about, chosen and born. In fact, the high points are made possible because I had the courage to go through the valley of Baca. When I'm going through something now, I go back to Baca. I go down in the valley. I take a drink from the spring. When my thirst is quenched, I feel like going long because I know I'm on my way to Zion. We can say in the words of Bishop Shelby Spahn, if God is the source of life, then the only way you worship God is by living. Living fully, sharing life, giving it away. Not being afraid, wandering out of the certain, and first going into the uncertain, out of the known into the unknown. That would also include having the courage, each and every one of us, to go through the valley of Baca. Going through something is a part of life. I don't care who you are, you're going to go through something. If you call yourself a follower of Jesus, going through something is part of our faith. Didn't Jesus go do something? They arrested him in Gethsemane. They put him on trial. They nailed him to a cross. They took the crown of thorns on his head. He cried out from the cross, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Yes. But that still led to resurrection.
Yes.
See, I've been through struggle. I've been through sickness. Been through trouble. Been through midnight. Been through mishap. Been through hardship. Been through hard knocks. But I'm here to tell you, I'm going through the valley of Baca. You can say, through it all. Through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. Yeah. beggars of despair in the springs of hope. When he like a river attends my way over sorrows like sea billows roll. Whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. Though Satan may buffet, though beggars should come, let this blessed assurance control that Christ has regarded my helpless estate and shed his own blood for my soul. I'm going